Hey everyone, I'm Ryan. You're watching 60 Cycle Hum, and this is The Mood by Chase Bliss Audio. What is the mood? What does the mood do? Who is the mood for? I'm going to say that if you are an ambient, experimental, or noise musician, you probably already know everything about this pedal. You might have even already bought one, or it's at the top of your Christmas list. And I don't blame you, because this pedal is like a love letter just for you. All you other musicians out there, all you regular guitarists that don't like to get weird and freaky, get lost, squares. This is for the freaky people. This is for the outsiders and the weirdos. It's not for you. So anyways, I'm going to describe the basic controls here, and then I'm going to use the power of the written word through captions to describe the settings as I go, because there is a lot of ground to cover and we don't want to waste time talking, do we? All right, left hand side, you have a bank of three different settings. You have slip, delay, and reverb. Right hand side, this is the looping side. You've got stretch, tape, and envelope settings. This isn't a normal looper. You don't press this, record your loop, press it again for the loop to play. It is always listening. It's listening right now. The LED flashing means that's the length of time that it is recording a loop. So you just press this once and it loops what you were already playing previously, what it already heard. This switch right here determines the signal path of the pedal. Right now it's set up so that the wet side affects only the dry signal of the guitar. You can set it up so that it will only affect the loop, or you can set it up so it'll affect the loop and the guitar. This is, you know, the last thing in the line of the signal path here. Then this is important. You really need to know about this knob. This is the clock knob. This adjusts the sample rate of both sides together at the same time. So you can turn it to the left for a really low sample rate that gives you a really long loop or delay signal or reverb signal, whatever you're messing with. You can turn it to the right for a really short, hi-fi sort of sound. There's a lot to mess around with there. And of course, you get a loop going, you twist this, and you can change the pitch, you can change the length, you can get experimental, you can get creative. That's really what this pedal's all about, is getting creative. So let's get into it. Here is my dry signal from my Titan Macaur loaded with P90s. I've got it with a little bit of drive on there just to differentiate between the dry signal of the guitar and the wet signal of the mood. Let's start out with the wet side, and please enjoy these captions. Hopefully there's not too many spelling errors. Here we go.
Thank you.
Well, that's been the mood. I just barely scratched the surface with this thing. I showed you the main functions of the different settings, and I got into the dip switches a little bit. I mean, all these dip switches up here, you can assign functions like ramp, bounce, expression control to any of these knobs here, going any direction you want with various ranges, combined with other knobs going other directions and other ranges. It's pretty incredible. You've also got MIDI control. You've also got two preset slots in this pedal, one on the left, one on the right. It's easy to save those presets through a series of holding down these foot switches. Man, just another wild pedal from Chase Bliss. This isn't for everyone. This thing makes wild, freaky sounds, but the people who want those wild and freaky sounds, like, where else are you gonna get it? This pedal does it. It is pretty crazy. So anyways, thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, dislike, leave me your rude and nasty comments. Support us on Patreon, buy a shirt, blah, blah, blah. Click the links down below to visit Chase Bliss and check out everything that they have on their website about this. So stay grounded. Bye, everybody.